Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sundio. I might as well get straight into your comments, aren't I? Subtitle said, I said it before, Charlie, you have a good voice for reading books. I see it more in your future. Oh, thank you very much, Mystic Meg. I am doing Goldilocks, but the pages are going a bit long. It's 3 pages long, and I'm only about a third of the way through. If you want the longer version, let me know in the comment section down below. The Bohemians put, Happy Sunday Outside, a good evening viewing Countryfowl Antiques Roadshow, then Charlie's Sunday Outside, hope you feel better. Thank you very much, Bohemian. It's just general life stuff at the moment, but that's not why people watch YouTube, isn't it? You want to get away from all the general life sort of stuff and just fill your mind with entertainment. Thomas Gallagher's put, Hi Charlie, excellent Sunday Outside, thank you for reading my comments out on video always, and lovely background and my favorite YouTube channel. Thank you very much, Thomas. I like doing YouTube, I like doing my Sunday Outside. I'm only in the garden this time, next to the poor dead conifer tree that suddenly random decided to die. Subtitle put, you might need to get some weights or some velcro ties to tie your tripod down to a tree so it doesn't blow over. It's because of my height that the reason why the tripod keeps blowing over, because the tripod is just not tall enough. I'm 5'10" and this only goes up to about, I think it's like 5'9", 5'9½", which means that I've always got to have it propped up a bit precariously to get the height where it's not set down properly. And Gladys put, I'm glad my profile picture made you laugh, lol. It is funny because you leave lovely comments and you've called Angry Lad with an angry profile picture. It's funny. And that's all the comments from last Sunday Outside. Let's go to Monday Meander, which was the next video. And I meandered too. I didn't have much of a meander, did I? Because I was a bit glum. And I decided just to go home. But I did get 2 bus videos out of it. And I'll get more into that subject in a minute. Ryan Five also has put, better watch out, the guilt-free labelling on the vending machine is going to send Demi Lovato into another frenzy. Oh, there's some sort of stupid story at the moment where she thinks she owns words, I think, isn't it? I don't know too much about it. It was in passing. I know that she's in some sort of litigation with something. Some people are legacious. Ligitatious, whatever the word is. It's hard to pronounce, isn't it? Where they just sue over anything. It's ridiculous. Subtitle put, you, passing pigeon, do you have anything to say on the matter? This is a very artsy high street. A lot of empty stores. There's another one. Yes, it was a shame, but things will pick up again, but unfortunately, that's just the way things are at the minute. A bit gloomy, isn't it? The Chained Oak has put, I love how the first noise you make is a jolly giggle. Oh, thank you very much. Yes. It was a bit random though, wasn't it, where the bus stops, just right at the back of Morrison's like that. Why didn't it drop all the customers off at Morrison's and then just go into, this bus terminates here. Please take all your belongings with you. I can tell I've done that a few times. Ryan Favre has put, I hope that you picked up some spray or Gorilla Glue to review this week, Charles. No, I did not. Shane Hall's put, I agree, graffiti needs to be done well. I like the picture ones like you, especially when they paint buildings on buildings. It looks interesting and fun. I hate it when they're just sort of graffiti. It looks horrible. It's an eyesore. I enjoyed the video. Yeah, I can't stand graffiti where they just think a tag or a word or initials is somehow art. It's not. It's not. Art is making something, not destroying something. Andrew Reeks has put, up, you're feeling better, Charlie. Thank you very much, Andrew. Sonia's put, nothing better to do, huh? Oh, yeah, I've got to say that proper, haven't I? Nothing better to do, huh? I also agree that graffiti is a big eyesore unless it's decent, talented work. The graffiti on the vans is horrible too. That is horrible. And I'm seeing it more and more in London at the moment. It looks absolutely awful. It looks really end of the world disgusting. And the people who do it are untalented, poor effort, rubbish people. I prefer independent coffee shops and cafes, etc. You were up and out very early. I enjoyed Wonder Meander. I am sorry to hear that you're not feeling good, Charlie. Thanks, Sonia. Thank you. Rebecca Trafford has put, if it rains on a Sunday, would you consider Sunday outside in a tent whilst drinking a hot drink from a flask so nothing gets in your drinks, steam coming from your cup, and would be really cosy, obviously in your garden for safety with a light so it's glowing as well. Just a suggestion, and if you're rather not, no worries. Also, this was uploaded today, but the pub says opens April the 12th. I know, yeah, it was a bit strange. The tent thing, yeah, I mean, I do have the tent, don't I? I have the pop-up tent and everything. But do you know what? It barely rains. You see a lot of the things that I see on YouTube, there's a lot of Americans that have moved to England. Mostly it's always London. In the case of Alana, who's Canadian, she's moved to Kent. It barely rains down here at all. And so getting the tent out and everything would be a rare thing. If you go back to all my Sunday outsides, and there have been a lot of Sunday outsides, haven't they? It's been going for 4 years now. You'll actually notice it barely rains. It really rarely rains in London, down south. When people say it always rains, I think that's just a, what's the word? A cliche, isn't it? Because you always do that, don't they, in American films. It's always a cliche. They'll show it raining, a red bus and a red phone box. Or not something else, if it's not a black taxi. Oh yeah, they've got to show the Houses of Parliament and Big Ben or something to give really a big strong indication that it's London. As if that's all that's in this country is London. The Bohemian was put, it'd be like if in England, if we made a film of America, like loads of films of America, and we kept using the same shots all of the time, what would we use to symbolise America? Probably a McDonald's with, what's the biggest? It's probably going to have to be something in New York. Probably the Statue of Liberty would probably symbolise, stereotypically, what we'd think of America. It would be the New York side of things. Maybe the White House, maybe, depending on the genre of the film. But I think generally it would be New York and Manhattan and Statue of Liberty, all that sort of area shown. Bohemian's put, I hope you're feeling better today, Charlie. How are your tomato plants? Oh, the tomato plants are there, and I can show you them. They're growing. And happy Sunday outside. Thank you very much. Yes, the tomato plants are finally growing. I'm growing them from seed. And I put cling film around them, didn't I, to sort of make a fake, very cheap greenhouse. But, yeah, they're growing. I'll show you them at the end. Thomas Gallagher's put, hi, Charlie. Excellent Monday meander. I hope you're feeling better soon. And lots of empty stars. And I agree, graffiti needs to be done well. I like the picture ones. Thank you for your videos. And always have a lovely weekend. Yes, the picture graffiti ones are so much better. I didn't show you the Prince Philip one, and it was like a memorial to him that they'd spray painted on one of the shutters with the date of his birth and death. And it looked really good. It really looked like him. It was a really good picture. Georgina Rawcroft has put, oh, Charlie, sweetheart, I hope you are soon back to feeling yourself. But it was a nice Monday meander. Anyway, I watched them on my big tablet, and it's like a virtual bus ride around London. I love it, as always. You're maybe just tired. Have a chillax. Ugh, as I say. You've not watched that video that I made way back, probably in about 2015. It makes it sound like a cooling laxative, I said. Chillax. I should have really trademarked that as a cooling laxative. Then everyone would have just stopped saying chillax. Although they pretty much have, haven't they? People have stopped saying it. Like bae. People have stopped saying bae. Oh, he's my bae. You know, BAE. It's like, oh, British Airways Enterprises. Is your British Airways Enterprises, is he? You know what I mean? Each to their own. I'm joshing. I'm laughing off. I'm having a laugh. I couldn't get over how much graffiti that was done any old how and ruined the nice ones. I know, yeah, people have graffitied over with a stupid word or something. You didn't paint that lovely picture. You've just destroyed it. You know, and oh, I hate that. Anyway, Charlie, stay safe and well and see you soon. Take care. Thank you very, very much, Georgina. Ryan V has put Cheer Up Charlie. We've had conversations about that, have we not, Ryan Fav? Rebecca Trafford has put £1.70 for a Coke. That says in the words of Jim Royal, bloody highway robbery. Yeah, the World's End pub was the actual pub featured in the film. Probably, yeah. Yes. Ryan Favre's put, was disappointed to see you went hula hooping. I'm not going to hula hoop through London. That would be just dangerous. There's too many people about. And you're going to get one numpty who's just going to grab over the hold of the hula hoop and fling it under a bus or something. Kane Southern's put, I was up at 5 a.m. Yes, I was up very early to do that video. And it needed to be done, because to do them bus videos, you've got to be up very early, because otherwise it's going to stop at every single bus stop, get caught in all the traffic, and then there's the traffic lights as well. And that is Monday Meander videos done. Let's move swiftly on now to Tuesday Reviews days. And I reviewed the Insane Grain, didn't I? Now, Insane Grain was these expensive knockoffs of what I thought was going to be like Watsits in Whole Foods, but they were not. They weren't very good. Poon Killer was put here, before this guy breaks the internet, what a legend. Thank you very much. Thank you. Ryan Farvers put, I was sure you'd be reviewing Gorilla Glue today. How silly am I? Very. Thomas Gallagher's put, hi Charlie, good video. Thank you very much. Georgina Rawcroft has put, always nice to see your happy face and your giggle. Always makes me laugh. Luminek, not much there in there, is the blimey. Always does good reviews. Our Charlie with milk. Oh my, heck, Charlie has invented something. You need to copyright your idea. Yeah, crisps and milk. crisps and cereal in one. you need to copyright your idea, except the vile ones. Vile. Your face says it all. Is it me, or have you got rose cheeks? As always, a pleasure to watch. Nice to see you feeling better. Probably didn't have rosy cheeks. No, it was probably just the way the lighting was at the time. Kane Southern 212 was put, I always like Tuesday Reviews Day. Oh, thank you very much. Tuesday Reviews Day does reasonably all right, doesn't it? Yeah, the reason why I have Tuesday Reviews Day is to keep things sort of tidy on my channel, because I do so much different things, that's great English, so many different things, that I need some organisation, so that when people come onto my channel, they can hopefully just type in the word, and then that way they'll find me. The Bohemian's put, have you any full bags of crisps left from your crispitarian diet? You're still to try Eastern European crisps. Nice cheesy flavours, paprika, sour cream and onions as well. I've not got any of them crisps. Usually when I finish a challenge, I usually eat significantly less of that food for a while. Except with baked beans. I still eat beans, but significantly less than what I used to. DJ3 Electrical Return has put... DJ3 Electrical Return has put... The only insane thing about this is the insane amount of blandness and the insane amount of info on the back of the pack. I don't know why they do that. Small startup companies are really over-the-top, pretentious, health, organic, vegan, vegetarian, no butterflies even set foot into our factory foods. You know, they always go over the top with a blurb. And they're always talking about where they're about and where they're coming from. Like, we've never heard all that story before. We don't care. We just want something that tastes good for the money that we've paid for it. We don't want more choice. We want nicer things. And if you want to put all that blurb, write a book. Don't make a product. And because it feels as if you've spent more time writing this stuff on the back of a bag than you have thinking, does this actually taste good? It really annoys me. Shane Hall has put, after my house arrest, I will not rush out to buy them as they seem boring. They were very boring. Although putting the salted caramel ones in milk was delicious. by the way, obviously, I'm reading out all of everyone's comments. If I've missed any of you off, it's because YouTube have randomly deleted your comment, which is very annoying. because I hope Hunter Sunday outside is to read your comments. Is it not? The next one is London Bus 148, Shepherd's Bush to Camberwell Green Heath, 2021 in real time. What a catchy title. But it has to include everything so people actually watch it. Except it does not, unfortunately. Right, Ben Stocks has put, I always find buses confusing, especially London buses, but I guess living there a long time, you'd get used to it. Yeah, I mean, they've always got the voice thing on telling you which bus stop is the next bus stop. The only time it's annoying is when they're on diversion because of roadworks. And sometimes heavy traffic can annoy some people. It don't really bother me as much unless I was on the way to work. But I don't mind sitting in a traffic jam, especially if it's a Sunday outside or a Monday meander, because it's just nice just to sit there and actually look around and see things. But the most confusing thing about buses is probably the switch, what they do for the timetables, because most of the timetables I like are the ones that I use in my thumbnail picture, where it shows you the strip and it shows you the times and how often they're going to be and this, that and the other. But in central London, they've got these lines going the opposite direction with circles, and they're really confusing. I don't like them ones. Thomas Gallagher's put, hi Charlie, great video as always. Nice to see London. I do enjoy it so much. Thank you for the video. Thank you very much. The Bohemians put, I'm not a disliker for these videos, but I'm a non-watcher. But a thumbs up for this video, Charlie. I bought today the Linda McCartney vegan sausages. They taste the same as normal veggie Linda sausages, but a bit drier and chewier. I've not had the vegetarian ones. I think I've only had the vegan ones, haven't I? Is Linda McCartney vegetarian or vegan? I always forget. Anyway, the Linda McCartney sausages are nice, especially the rosemary and thyme ones. Oh, they're so good. Put them with a bit of barbecue sauce or tomato sauce, obviously. I'm salivating now thinking of that. Linda McCartney sausages are great. They're not real sausages, and I do prefer real sausages, you know, if we had the choice. But when I see Linda McCartney sausages on a real good price, like a pound from Iceland or something, I will get them. But It's harder to get the other flavoured ones, like the rosemary and thyme ones. Usually it's just the original ones. The rosemary and thyme ones just had that extra little bit of a... I'm actually salivating right now. They're that good. Just thinking about them makes you hungry for them and salivating for them. It's like my tongue's saying, well, come on then. Well, where's Linda McCartney's sausages? Why aren't you cooking them? Why aren't you eating them? Why am I salivating for no reason? Ryan V has put, if buses mince... I'm actually finishing the series quite soon for these bus videos because it's actually got a really poor audience rate, which is depressing. And someone else is doing the exact same thing as I'm doing, same quality and everything, and they're getting considerably more views. And I thought, well, there's no point trying to compete with that because I can do other stuff, because that's what this channel... what I have is all about, just doing different things. And if I'm doing the same as somebody else, there's no point, particularly if they're getting all the views for it and I'm not. It's quite an effort getting up at that time of the morning randomly through the week, because I'd get up at, sometimes I'd just stay up, but sometimes I'd get up at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning to be on the bus, because the only difference between my videos and the other people's is, when I get up early to do mine, at least then, the only time the bus really stops is at traffic lights, but the bus is usually going slow enough because it has to keep to its timetable. Because I thought it'd be quite boring if it's just stuck in traffic all the time. And I thought it'd be nice to see the views as the bus is going down its route and whatnot. And at that time of the morning, it's really nice because it's not stopping at every single bus stop. There's no traffic. The traffic lights still, but even at the traffic lights, it's the bus is usually at the very front of the traffic lights. So I thought my videos were better in that respect, but they're just not getting the views, and it's really dragging the channel down. And I think it's actually affected the way YouTube does my channel. And I've had problems with the algorithm recently because all my views have been right down these last couple of weeks, and it might be a coincidence, but I think it's because of the bus video, so I'm going to have to stop doing them. Unless something massive changes. I mean, if I wake up one morning and it's got 1,000 views, I might rethink my situation, but I'm going to stop it at number 10. And today, as I'm talking, number 7 is uploading, so I've got 3 more to actually film, edit, and do. even though the real time, you still got to put a little bit of editing into it. You know, you got to chop off the bit at the beginning where I'm running up the stairs or something, and at the very end where I'm going down the stairs, for instance. If any of that makes sense to you, or if you care, let me know in the comment section down below. But yeah, I liked making them, but unfortunately, they were just not popular. And even by my channel standards, it was dragging my channel down for audience retention and views, which affects all of my channel. It's just the way the YouTube algorithm works, and there's nothing I can do about that. Next video is the Orb Retro Arcade. This is a little computery sort of game, handheld thing, which I think I've had now for about 8 weeks or something. It's really, really good. I like it. And comments, come on. There we go. Shane Hollis, but I can remember my older brother having a Game Boy in the early 2000s. I never had an handheld game thing. It was one of them little LCD things. Do you remember? Like them car racing games and stuff like that. That's all we ever had. I didn't have a Game Boy or anything. John B has put the second song from the football game you didn't know is something from Mario. I feel like Super Mario Bros. 3. Not sure though. Edit. Checked the other comments. Seemed to be Dr. Mario. Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? It's almost as if they've robbed these things. Have they robbed it, or are they actually legitimately allowed to play these music things? I don't know. I'm glad to put that's a nice game system you've got there. It's really good because it's some daft little simple games. It really passes the time, and because it's not on a proper computer or anything like that, it's a nice wind down before I go to sleep, or if I just need to waste a couple of minutes, it's just nice to have that lying around. It's a shame the battery life isn't good enough though. I mean, like I said in the video, it should have had 3 AA's just to lengthen its life. And I think the auto shut off just cuts off too quick. It should be 2 minutes, not 1 minute. DJ3 Electricals Returns put, these are very common in gadget shops and toy stores. It's often that they illegally rip off a load of music from popular games, as seen here with all the Sonic tunes used here. And all them games on them are often the same generic games but reskinned. There's a lot of genericism going on in the machine and repetition from them 153 games. Several of the games are just identical. And but yes, do you know what? I really miss the gadget shop. I know it technically is Red Farve now, but the gadget shop actually was based in Hull, and it was based in Hesel, which is just outside of Hull. All the H's. There's also Hedden as well. But no, it was based in Hesel, and that's where the manufacturer was for the importing of all the goods and everything. But apparently it was boardroom bickering that led to the downfall of the gadget shop, which was a shame, because it used to always be in Princess Quay, and it was the first shop I'd go to. I used to have loads of little gadgety stuff when I was a kid. I loved all the little gadgets and everything I used to have. And then it went bust. WH Smith, they bought the gadget shop name, and they've just done nothing with it. And it's the most boringest range now. It's stupid. Thomas Gallagher's put, hi Charlie, excellent video. Thank you very much. Georgina Rawcroft has put, I remember my two lads having something like this, but I can't remember what games they had on them. The music sounds a lot like Sonic the Hedgehog. I may be wrong, my eldest son is 39 now, so my memory isn't so good. But I remember they used to drive me mad, all the music on them whilst I was trying to watch my TV. Oh yes, you've said Sonic the Hedgehog, thank you Charlie. They used to sit for hours playing on them till Donkey Kong came out and Diddy Kong. Blimey, the memories. You're still young at heart, Charlie, laughing my head off at your Alvin Chipmunk voice. Yeah, I speeded it up, didn't I, a bit all the way through, because I was ticking for ages trying to find that game that I liked on the machine. Because it only gives you a one-word title. It'd be nice if in the background it changed so that you could see whatever was highlighted, what game it was. But that's asking a bit too much for something that's £6, isn't it? Ryan Favers, but when will you play Tipping Point? When that video gets 10,000 views, I did the third one, didn't I? And I do keep an eye out for a machine to update game, but I haven't been able to find one recently. Ryan Favre's put, posting on behalf of K Danny, who says that his comments keep getting deleted for some reason. Shrugs. That's weird. That's annoying. Yeah, I haven't seen K Danny's comments for a while, actually. The theme on football is Dr. Mario. Magic Stone is Tetris. Maybe Puyo Puyo. Yeah, I remember that game as Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine. Oh, God, I'm so addicted to that game. It's so good. 1422 is Zuma. 1625 is Space Invaders. Oh! And 1912 is Spy Hunter. And that's basically everything I know. And as you said, you are a Sonic fan. Get the Genesis / Mega Drive Mini. But overall, it looks basic. I did have the handheld thing a couple of years ago of the Mega Drive. I loved that, but it broke. I wore it out. The directional button just stopped working, which was incredibly annoying. It broke halfway through a game as well. I was like, no, what's happening? Big Joe Angels put, I bought one of these things recently. I got the 500-in-1 Ultra Slim Retro Game console. It has a rechargeable battery. Oh, that's good. And is more of a Game Boy shape. I think it contains actual NES games that are emulated. I'm sure they've ripped off ROMs and not strictly legal, but that's China for you. Good for a tenner, a bit of a gimmick. Yeah, and I wonder how they managed to get away. The sun has just come out of the cloud and decided to illuminate me and right into my eyes. If I was just like there, which I'll move to. That's just reminded me, actually, I need to show you the tomato plants, don't I? Well, yes, I wonder how they thought that using that music they'd get away with it. I don't know. Rebecca Trafford has put, the first games console me and my bros had was the Nintendo. It was a grey box, which I'm sure you remember, Charlie. Remember me and my bros thinking, wow, it was around 1989 to 1990. We thought it was amazing because before we didn't have any games console, so it was special. Similar thing with me and my sister. We got the Mega Drive in 1994. And that was, we'd got that, but it was also the same Christmas that my grandma died. My grandma died on the 9th of December, and they'd already bought the Mega Drive and everything. And she died, and it was a really weird Christmas, that one. It's one of the things, obviously, you remember all your life, I suppose, because we was devastated, and because my grandma was she was only 59 and dying like that, and then obviously being kids and everything at the same time. On Christmas Day we opened up a Mega Drive, but we were still really sad because we didn't see our grandma, and it's really, really awfully sad to be like, oh, we've got a Mega Drive, and it was just a weird feeling. It was almost like being split in half, and one half of you just wanted to cry because you knew that your grandma had helped pay for this Mega Drive, because obviously they weren't cheap, and then the other side of you was like really, really happy, and then realizing that you weren't able to say thank you. It was horrible, but the sad side of that apart, obviously that was a long time ago, 1994. The Mega Drive was great. Love the Mega Drive. I preferred the Mega Drive to the Nintendo. Ben Stocks has put, I'm not really much of a gamer, but I own one of those mini NES consoles. Not sure if you've seen them or not. But if I'm honest, I prefer those games with the Xbox and PlayStation games. Haha. Yes, later on, I think it was 2000 and... I think it was 2001 we got the PlayStation. I think it was 2001 we got the PlayStation. You know, the original one. But I think, I can't remember as much. And I prefer Mega Drive games and PlayStation games. Yeah. They use them at games machines, didn't they, at the moment, where they're just like emulators and re-put together stuff of the Mega Drive and stuff. The handheld one was made by At Games, and that was good, but I've seen some At Games stuff which is absolutely dreadful. Kane Southern 212 was, but I had one of them, but it was a different brand. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think it's just the same actual guts, just with a new skin put around it, because there is the another version of it in Robert Dias that looks more like a Game Boy sort of thing, but that one does actually have a directional pad on it, but it's the buttons are underneath the screen, which makes it incredibly difficult to play. Jan Brenner's put, is this made by our Chinese overlords? Yes, it was. And Scar's put, like Ashens, but not. I know, I should have done it on the set, shouldn't I, with a brown background, but I don't want to be done by copyright because I don't know, maybe Ashens is a brand now. And it might get very upset with me. I don't know. Next video is Weird Thought, and I eat lemons. I like eating lemons on their own. Juicy, tasty, delicious, and no one steals them, you know? It's not like an apple or an orange. People leave lemons well alone. Unless there's some gin in the house, do you know what I mean? But very delicious. Comments that Jonathan Ries, hello, has put, Charlie, you should try sour beer since you like sour things. I love it, but it's usually more expensive than regular beer. Consider that a topic video request. Sour beer? I don't think I've ever seen that before. The sun's just come back in my eyes again. And Darren Juden-Gardner has put, that made my cheeks taut. The enamel was running from my teeth watching you eat those. You'd probably enjoy apple cider vinegar. I probably would. The only time I've seen that, though, is in Waitrose, and it looks quite expensive for a bit of vinegar. Luke has put, nout nicer than a lemon on a red hot day. Love it when you get fruit in drinks and when you go out. Hate trying to get them out inconspicuously when it's a posh place. Oh, I just stick my fingers in my drink right there. I don't care. Thomas Gallagher's put, hi Charlie, excellent video, lol. I do like lemon in the cake, but not eat like that. You have a lovely weekend. You too, thank you very much, and have a good week. Gordon Ramsay's put, delicious lemons. Dudina Rawcroft has put, oh Charlie, you're so much like my two sons. One ate lemons like you. My eyes are watering and other literally drank vinegar out the bottle. I think it is a northern thing. I used to like to drown my chips in vinegar. Oh yeah, fish and chips, especially at Old Fair with Bob Carver's, it's probably getting drenched. The chips are practically floating in the vinegar. Jonathan Sims has put, I eat lemons too. Charlie, love them. Exactly, Jonathan Sims. And if you find as well, absolutely nobody messes with the lemons. They just will steal everything else, but the lemons will leave well alone. Micah Peters has put, have you tried lemons with the little red berries that make them taste sweet? I've not, no. They use that thing, isn't it? Because I've seen it on QI, where Stephen Fry has them things. And you put it in your mouth, and then when you eat a lemon, it's apparently makes the lemon taste sweet because it covers over the sour parts of your tongue or something. The Bohemians put, I'm impressed, no scary for you then. Exactly. Shane Hollis put, I like eating lemons and limes. They are great. Oh yeah, limes. I do the same with limes as well, but limes are smaller, aren't they? So you don't get as much from them. Angry Lad has put, nice. I love lemons on pancakes. Yes, lemons are great. Ryan Favre has put, a teaspoon of vinegar is good for getting rid of hiccups. Well, that's good information. So, because I get hiccups quite often, and I really hate it. And because, like I say, I'm always really scared. It's the beginning of when you hear people get hiccups for 20 years. I'm always scared that this is the beginning of 20 years of hiccups. Sloppy Turtle's put, when will the self-torture end with you, Charlie? Have you not seen the baby tries lemon for the first time videos here on YouTube? And the baby ends up having to go to a hospital and the parents laugh obnoxiously. Because we're a sick society over here in the US. Charlie, you know what I saw recently? Where salt and vinegar chips advertised here in the US. The UK's bad eating habits have floated across the American pond. I love the joke because it's like America gives us McDonald's, Burger King, KFC, Kraft. Oh my word, so much. Oh, even Hershey. That all comes bulled over the flipping Pacific Ocean. Pacific Ocean? Atlantic Ocean. And then one little bag of salt and vinegar crisps floats back on the back wave. And suddenly that's an invasion of the UK's bad eating habits. Scar's put, that's not right, lad. I'm not right at all, am I? I'm completely loopy. And we'll run to the last video, which is the Aldi Burgers, which I put up last night. And there we go. Gordon Ramsay's put, they look stunning. They was just all right, the burgers. I think it's because I've spoilt myself now, because I own the Aberdeen Angus burgers now. I think if these had been Aberdeen Angus burgers with the chili on or with the cheese on, they would have been absolutely fantastic. But there was not. Thomas Glad to watch the excellent video. I will look forward to Sunday outside tomorrow. I hope you're enjoying it today. Some potatoes put, you're getting stiffed over, lol. You make it sound abnormal. Charlie, some people would happily entertain a good stiff. I like your lounge cover and plum colour pillows. At 9:58, hot soapy water. Is that another accentism that I'm going to get pulled upon? Hot soapy water. Hot soapy water. Some potato went on to say, actually cleaning the grill with roll, or even bog roll. I love that term, lol. What, bog roll? It's better for me, it's better for the sewers because it puts the fat in the bin instead of going down the plug hole and causing bunged up sewers. That London and other cities are having excess fats, wipes, nappies and items that shouldn't go down the loo or plug hole. Oh, absolutely, yeah. I mean, I'd scrape off the majority of the gunk off the grill. But, you know, at the very end, I'd rather be able to then put them plates in the dishwasher because I wouldn't want to clog the dishwasher up with fats and stuff. And I'd want to put the plates in some hot soapy water. I said the H then for you, to make sure I'm not saying oh. The double glottal words. You know, the ones that end and start with H's and T's. Oh, it, eh, het, and oh, hut. But yeah, oh, absolutely, yeah. I never pour oils or fats down the plug hole. Janine Rowcroft has put, oh, Charlie, I always look forward to your reviews. Always interesting and appreciated. Charlie's singing, you are funny when your eyes are funny when you're doing a laugh. But these blooming adverts, guru, do a chuffing head in. Anyway, back to your review. I wait with bated breath. Oh, I like your cheese. I forgot the name. Jarlsberg. Oh, there's Sherlock. It would be nice to see him at some point. He's very well spoken, I must say. So you're not salivating with this one. Yeah, they weren't great. The burgers were all right. They weren't brilliant. I was nearly going to say they weren't great, but it was all right. What bread cakes are they? I got them from Waitrose. It was the basics Waitrose ones. They're so thin and wobbly, but they look very substantial. See you, Charlie. See you, Sherlock. Can't wait to see your Sunday outside and comments. Thank you very much. The premium's put, I've been offered by a friend, Herr George from and Grill. Is this better than using a cooker oven type grill? I prefer to grill than fry. Is this a quicker way to grill peppers? Linda McCartney sausages, Iceland veggie burgers, etc. No meat, etc. Hope you feel better. Happy Sunday outside. Thank you very much, the Bohemian. Yeah, I do like the George Foreman grill. If you can get one with removable plates, excellent. But it is really good because it cooks a lot quicker because there's heat on the bottom and the top. And it like sandwiches the heat in. It's not good for stuff that I've got a coating on because that's just going to bend to the top part of the grill. But it's good for like Linda McCartney sausages and normal plain burgers and whatnot. It's good for that kind of stuff. Scars put, what would Sherlock look like? I wonder what Sherlock looks like. That's a wonder away. The real Matthew Elias put, listen to the two lovers. Angry Lads put, lovely. Ryan Favre's put, Sherlock's face reveal at 1 million subs. That's never going to happen. I am never going to have 1 million subscribers. Never. I'm never going to get a plaque. I've realised that many years ago now. I am not going to ever be. I think YouTube, I always have this feeling that YouTube would actually close down just shy. Even in my wildest dreams, in a whole year of Sundays, not just a month of Sundays, a whole year of Sundays, a year of Sunday outsides, that just as I got to the million, YouTube shuts down or something, or discontinues the plaques. You know, that'd be just my luck. Shane Ells put, I like Aldi beef burgers. Yeah, that was all right. And Ryan Fowles put, oh, for goodness sake, do you have to eat with your mouth open? Which is a gimme, gimme, gimme quote. Well, thank you everyone so much for watching. Please go ask Bermlet in the comment section down below anything you want to know. There has been changes to the adverts. Previously, on my YouTube videos, I'd have ads at the beginning and ads set at the very end, and then put one set of ads through my videos. That's had to change because with my sudden drop in advertising, revenue and with everything to that. And I make very little as it is anyway. I think I barely break even. I think I make my YouTube videos at a loss. But I just couldn't, I can't go on like this. I've added two extra breaks into my longer videos because when a video is more than 8 minutes, then you can put adverts in the middle of your videos. Now, you can do them manually or you can do them automatically. Now, I've got a feeling that if I press the automatic button, it'd absolutely cram my videos with adverts. But I'm now putting in my longer videos, 3 blocks of adverts. It is very annoying. I'm very sorry about that. But I hope you can overcome that. It's still significantly less than what some YouTubers do, where they put adverts in almost like every minute, which is just greediness and really annoying and distracting for the viewer. Anyway, I'm going to show you my tomato plants and I'm going to go. But for now, scratch spell me. Bye. Right. There's my tomato plants growing. Look, I can't remove the cling film because I don't want... I can do that though if I flick it. There we are. You can see in a bit more. Because I've got to keep it, like... Oh, that's better, look. I can actually hold it right up. They're growing! Yes. 100 tomatoes. I want 100 tomatoes at least out of this. I can't wait till it's fully grown and is covering this completely. Oh, it's come out. There we are. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scratch spell me. Bye!